A young voice silenced, an old friend accused, and a shattered husband looks for justice.
I want her to pay for what she did. You know, my wife didn't deserve it.
Song, sex appeal, and style. She was a rising star, poised to become the next Madonna. But on March 31st, the music was silenced. This is a VH1 news special, Selena, Music, Tragedy, and Trial.
Nearly 7 months ago, the Latin music world was stunned when one of its most promising stars was gunned down. And now the trial of Selena Quintanilla's alleged killer is underway. Hello, I'm Amy Scott from Houston, Texas. This is a city known for championship basketball, oil wells, and space travel. But now, the only thing that's making news around here is the trial of Yolanda Saldivar.
The former manager of Selena's fan club, Yolanda Saldivar, is accused of gunning down the Tejano singer sensation last March in Corpus Christi.
What the Simpson trial was to the nation, the Saldivar trial is to Texas. This was Selena's home.
The lawyers are now faced with making their strikes.
The media is hanging on every word of testimony, and so are her fans.
She stole from Selena, and then she lied, then she killed her.
Selena fans who gather daily outside the courthouse believe that this is a cut-and-dried case. An eyewitness testified that he heard a shot and saw Selena running and screaming, Saldivar chasing her with a gun pointed at her back.
This is a simple case of murder. That's what we've been saying all along. That's what we intend to prove.
Despite confessing to police that she shot Selena, Saldivar has pleaded not guilty. And as the Quintanilla family file into the courthouse each day under tight security, they're outraged that the defense is claiming the gun discharged accidentally.
And if they don't have some good, credible, competent proof to support that theory, it will blow up.
The prosecution says that the defense is trying to cloud the case by portraying Selena's father, Abraham Quintanilla Jr., as a control freak who resented Saldivar's personal and professional relationship with his daughter.
If the defense does not have a nexus, that means a bridge from the father's controlling to the, quote, irrationality of Selena on the day of the murder, another atomic bomb for the defense.
The defense team is hoping that the jury, comprised of 4 Hispanics, 7 whites, and 1 African American, will buy Saldivar's story.
I have come to believe in her strongly, and I think the jury will believe in her strongly before the case is over.
As the prosecution argument continues, fans are also outraged at defense cross-examination tactics aimed at tarnishing Selena's image, an image that the Quintanillas have dedicated themselves to uphold. It's likely to continue, however, as the defense gets to mount its case. The trial is expected to continue for at least one more week. All across America, thousands of young men and women are working toward a dream, a fantasy of fame, fortune, and stardom, making music and touring the world. But an unseen side of stardom is the danger that lurks around too many corners. It's a danger that claimed the life of John Lennon more than a decade ago, and it claimed Tejano sensation Selena on March 31st. Their music was very different, but their tragedies were very similar. Both careers snuffed out with the pull of a trigger. Here's VH1's Ian O'Malley.
There was chaos outside the Days Inn Motel in Corpus Christi. A huge police SWAT team had their guns trained on a red pickup. Inside the truck, a woman with a gun to her head. Rumors of a shooting spread quickly. Then the phone rang.
My mom had called in, and my aunt was crying and was in hysterics. Something happened to Selena.
A.B. and his father headed directly to the hospital. They arrived at the emergency room doors with no idea of what to expect. Seconds later, they discovered the horrible truth.
They asked me to identify a ring, that one of her rings, and I identified the ring, and that's when we went in the hospital, and the doctor had said that when she came in that she was brain dead.
Selena was pronounced dead at 1:05 p.m.
When I went up and met with the detective, he started describing the lady that shot her. I said, dang, man. You know, it was just unimaginable.
A.B. knew exactly who the suspect was, family friend and employee Yolanda Saldivar. Shortly before noon that day, Selena arrived at the motel to confront Saldivar. She suspected that Saldivar had been mishandling money from the boutiques and fan clubs she was hired to manage. Minutes later, according to a motel maid, Selena ran out of room 158 screaming for help when she was struck by a bullet in the back from a .38 caliber revolver.
When I saw the lady shooting at her, I went into like a shock. I didn't know whether to yell or just hide.
Witnesses say that Selena managed to name her assailant before collapsing in the motel lobby.
I know she was terrified because she ran. She ran from the outside of the door of the hotel room to the lobby.
After a 9.5 hour standoff, Yolanda Saldivar finally surrendered to police, and mainstream America was finally about to discover Selena.
A 23-year-old woman whom Mexican-American teenagers in this country compared to Madonna was shot and killed in Corpus Christi, Texas today.
As many as 50,000 mourners converged on Corpus Christi to pay their respects. Overwhelmed by grief and shock, Selena's family, friends, and fans shared their tears and prayers at memorial services all across the country.
She just touched everybody's heart. She was a great person. She was never into drugs or nothing. And she just touched everyone's heart. And I know that God's with her right now. And our prayers, everyone's prayers are with her.
On the brink of fulfilling her dream of mainstream pop stardom, one of Latin music's brightest stars was cruelly extinguished, allegedly at the hands of her friend and number one fan.
Coming up, an interview with Selena's greatest fan, her husband.
VH1's Artist of the Month, Janet Jackson.
My heart, I always knew she had what it would take to be a successful star.
Selena was adored in the Hispanic community, and while she was born and raised in Texas, most people in this country had no idea who she was. But as VH1's Anthony DeCurtis tells us, all that was about to change. Her star was on the rise.
No me queda más si tu regreso sería.
While she was virtually unknown to most Americans, Selena was enormously successful. Before her death, she had sold nearly 2 million records, and she was one of the top 5 money earners among Latin entertainers. But to Selena's fans, her magic went far beyond her music.
She was a symbol of what can happen in this country, and to see somebody break through like that, and not just achieve success, but to achieve success on that great a scale, I mean, it's a very uplifting and very validating experience.
Her story was truly a tale of rags to riches. Selena Quintanilla was born and raised in the shadow of the oil patch towns that lined the Gulf Coast of Texas. When the oil boom went bust and Selena's father's restaurant went under, the family was forced to take to the road, and 9-year-old Selena's professional career was born.
Mira como ando, mi amor.
They'd travel from bars to weddings, where Selena would sing to put food on the table, backed by her dad on guitar, her sister on drums, and her brother on bass.
We barely had enough money to put gas in the van, and we stopped off for a deluxe dinner, which was a loaf of bread, a package of weenies, a big bag of corn chips, and a six-pack of Cokes.
Times were tough. But along the road, Selena was building a large and loyal following of Latino fans from the barrios of South Texas. Her popularity grew, but she never lost touch with her heritage.
That really struck a chord. That was very evident among her fan base, and that's why you had this outpouring after her death, this very strong outpouring of grief and sorrow among her fans. It was really one of them had been taken.
Her big break came in 1987, when at 15, Selena won the Teano Music Award for Best Female Entertainer. The honor landed her a deal with Capitol Records, which led to 6 increasingly successful Spanish albums. In 1993, Selena won a Grammy for Best Mexican-American Album, and commercial sponsors came calling. She had endorsement deals with the likes of Southwestern Bell, Coke, and Agree Hair Products. After 14 years of hard work, Selena was a star on both sides of the border. More than that, she had become a role model for legions of Latino fans who couldn't get enough of her unique blend of sexuality and family values. She had become a politically correct Madonna.
It really, it's a phenomenon that I think a select few artists, amongst all the wonderful artists that there are out there, that especially in such a short lifetime, can have an impact of this magnitude on so many people.
When Selena died, fans on two continents felt the pain. But nowhere is the pain as great as it is in her own home, where the loss is felt each and every day by the man who shared Selena's life and her career.
Right now I have, except for her, everything that I want. But I'd give it all up just to have her back. You know, because that's how much she meant to me.
As her guitarist, Chris Perez shared the stage with Selena. As her husband, he planned to share a lifetime with her. Just 2 days before their third wedding anniversary, Selena was murdered.
I feel like literally a big half of me, you know, half of me died with her. I feel like nothing's filled up that half. You know, I'm just there empty.
Saying goodbye to Selena was the hardest thing Perez ever had to do. At her funeral, Chris says he wanted to crawl into the coffin and be buried with her. Nearly 7 months have now passed, and he still has difficulty sleeping. He's lost a lot of weight and spends most of his days and nights playing guitar in the house where he and Selena lived.
Sometimes I feel like, only way I can say it is like so alone, you know, because I'm there in the house and her stuff is still in the same place it's been. I haven't moved anything. It's just strange. Some days you can walk in and out and you're okay. Like I said, in other days you walk in and out of the house and it's like, it's a real pain.
They planned on having children. Chris says Selena wanted 5. At the time of her death, they were designing a home to be built on 10 acres just outside Corpus Christi. Enough land to raise horses, something Selena always dreamed of doing.
Basically what I had to do is let go a lot of those dreams, you know, but it wasn't that hard because she's not here. That's the hard part, you know, having to deal with that. I mean, to be honest, I don't want the land without her, you know. I don't want that house without her. I don't want all that other stuff without her.
In the 6 years he toured with her band, Chris not only fell in love with Selena, but he grew very close to her entire family. He considers them his flesh and blood. Without their support, Chris says he wouldn't be able to cope with the pain.
Just to have somebody there who's missing her, you know, who's kind of going through what I'm going through, you know, they're missing the same person that I am. And they're in the same situation, and as far as that they can't pick up the phone and call her either. They can't go and pick her up from somewhere and bring her home, you know. Or if I need just to talk, they're there. If they need to talk, they know I'm here.
Only when Selena died did Chris realize the magnitude of his wife's popularity. He can't explain why so many people adored her, but he believes they loved her for the same reasons he did. Her beauty, her talent, her kindness, and her openness. Even after becoming a superstar, Selena insisted on remaining accessible. So accessible, Chris worried about her safety.
The thing about it is when you open yourself up like that, you're so vulnerable to, you know what I mean, to the people that you're trying to help or that you're being cool with. And it's just, I mean, look what happened to her, you know?
Chris is reluctant to talk about the woman on trial for killing his wife. He says that until recently, he's been too consumed by grief to think about her. But now, his anger for Yolanda Saldivar is coming to the surface.
I'll just end it right here. I know what happened, and it shouldn't have happened. And she should, you know, I want her to pay for what she did. You know, my wife didn't deserve it.
Chris admits to having little faith in the justice system. He says the damage is done, Selena is gone, and no verdict can change that. For her fans and family, Selena's spirit lives on through her music. For that, Chris is grateful. Selena's English album means the world to him, but listening to it can be difficult.
Late at night when all the world...
I'd be flipping through and I still can't to this day. When it comes out on the radio, one of the songs from that album, from the English album, I have to change it. It just kind of, it's a pain, you know. When I go home, though, that's the funny thing about it is I could pop in a tape of it. It's the same thing, or the CD, you know, and just sit back. And sometimes it's harder than others, but at least I could do it, you know.
Like her voice on the radio, images of Selena in her music video are constant and bittersweet reminders for Chris.
The first time I saw it, it was like just slicing the wounds open again, you know what I mean? It wasn't a good experience. It wasn't a happy experience, you know. That was my first reaction. Now I see it, and it's still, you know, it's kind of like a reminder that she's not here. That's how I see it. But then the other side of me is thinking, you know, that that's her video for her song, you know, that went to number one, that did so many good things. So it's kind of like I'm, you know.
At 26, Chris Perez says he's in no hurry to make decisions about his future. Right now, he guesses he'll return to playing music. He knows Selena would want him to get on with his life, but Chris says doing that will be difficult.
I can't say anything about it, you know, how I'm going to feel in another hour, much less, you know, in a year from now or something after what's happened. It's honestly, I still feel married, you know what I mean? Because I still feel that big part of her. I know legally it's not the case, but I still feel that way.
While her voice was silenced, her music lives on. When we come back, the rest of America discovers Selena.
The VH1 Weekends.
Because she was such an important attachment to her community, her memory might be a strong one. It might be really kept alive by her fan base, much like Elvis's music is kept alive by certain members of his fan base. I don't think she'll ever go away.
In the days following Selena's death, fans by the thousands flocked to Texas to say goodbye. Since then, millions more from Pennsylvania to the Pacific have heard her music. She's achieved the crossover star status that she and her band had hoped for. With her English album, Selena's dream has finally come true. VH1's A.J. Hammer has the story.
Hey, you know, hey, you need it. The hottest request on Kiss FM this morning. Who else? Selena, can you tell? She's hot.
Truer words have never been spoken. Since mid-July, when thousands lined up to be among the first to get their hands on her new album, Selena has been shattering sales records.
Sam Goody is a retailer with over 1,300 stores, so we sell a lot of music, and this will be our number one selling album.
Selena's English debut set a new record for first day and first week sales, making her the fastest selling female artist in history, surpassing Mariah Carey and Whitney Houston. And now, 3 months after its release, the album still holds the top spot on the Billboard charts.
In my heart, I always knew she had what it would take to be a successful star.
Who knows how many records she had in her, and who knows what she would have accomplished, but the potential was incredible, I think. It was just seriously the tip of the iceberg, which we were getting on this record.
While Billboard magazine says this album proves that greater mainstream success was in the offing, skeptics attribute its phenomenal sales to the publicity generated by Selena's murder. claims quickly dismissed by those who worked with her.
We can't change the tragedy. I mean, if we could, my God, I'd return all the records we've sold. We'd take her, like, right this second, because we would sell so many more records over the next 15, 20 years, because she was going to be huge, bigger than huge.
Some have charged Selena's family and her record company with exploiting a tragedy. Both resent the criticism. The Quintanillas are quick to point out that following Selena's death, pirates rushed to cash in, selling everything from t-shirts to unauthorized biographies. Soon, they'll have an authorized biography and video on the market, and a movie is in the works.
I would rather that our family put a movie out versus some B-rated producer or somebody that really knew nothing about her and just fabricated a story up and just smeared her good name and our family good name.
With Dreaming of You, Selena's proven her name is as good as platinum in any language. The Quintanilla family says, while it's gratifying to see the English album doing so well, without her here to enjoy it, the success is less than sweet.
It just really, it didn't mean anything, man. It's kind of like eating. You go every day and you eat, but the food just doesn't taste the same.
As bittersweet as Selena's success is for those who loved her, they remain committed to making her lifelong dream of being a pop superstar come true.
I've always felt that she's looking from up above somewhere. I really have always felt that. And that she's very proud of what we've done. And we have the responsibility to continue to carry her legacy and bring her wonderful music to the people.
Born Selena Quintanilla, she'll be remembered forever simply as Selena. As the trial progresses here in Houston, VH1 will be your eyes and ears to the courtroom proceedings and will bring you the verdict when it's delivered. I'm Amy Scott for VH1. Thanks for watching. You're always on my mind.